Why Rosh Hashanah? Rosh Hashanah is unique compared to the other holidays of the year. The Ramchal explained that at Rosh Hashanah, it's literally like a new creation. Why do we need Rosh Hashanah? I mean, we could do repent every day of the year. What's so special about it? So God wanted to pass us a message. God was saying, you know what? I create repentance, the power of repentance and mercy, which is part of the sphere of Keter, before the world was created. Why? Because I knew you were going to sin. I knew you were going to do mistake. I knew you'll mess up the world. But you know what? That's okay. You're a human being. You're allowed to make mistakes. What I really care is to see you change, to see how you go back up from your failures and how you're going to become a better person and use your free choice to do good. So when we come to Rosh Hashanah, God is telling us, hey, you can have a clean slate, start from the very beginning. Imagine for a second that you had no sin. You start from scratch. You create just like Adam Arishon. Rosh Hashanah is not the day of creation, of the creation of the world. It's the day when Adam was created. On the first day of Rosh Hashanah, until Chatzot, a little bit later actually, but until we do the Musaf, we are like Adam Arishon before the sin. We reenact, we relive, as if we go back in past, those original moments. Like Adam, the first man before his sin. If you had never sinned, and you came into this world, how would you behave? Would you think you will change with the compared to what you were before? See, God tell us, you know, I'm going to put all what you did in the past away, and I give you 10 days, the 10 days of repentance, to see what's the real you. How would you act if you knew you had never sinned? You see, the one of the problems is that the Yetzirah make us feel so bad because we sin, so feel so guilty. Guilt, which is not a Jewish thing, we feel so guilty that we say, ah, I sinned so many times, another sin, another time, ah, whatever, what can I do? It's okay. But the truth, it's not. Every little action count. And God is saying, I give you an opportunity to clean everything, and I'm putting all your past on the side for you to now choose to be a new person. And I'm going to judge you as if you're a new person. I just want to see what's the real you. So during those 10 days on Rosh Hashanah, we decide, I'm going to transform myself. I'm a new person. I'm like Adam Arishon before the sin. I can eat from the Etz HaChaim, the tree of life, or the Etz HaDas. So now, it's your choice. What tree are you going to choose? Which book you're going to choose to be written on? Make the choice. Transform yourself. Choose to be a pure person during the 10 days. Act as if you had never sinned. And see what you can become. And if you are able to experience that, and God, there's no way that He's gonna, God who loves you and is waiting just for you to change and to become that great person, He's gonna clean all your sins and elevate them. And there will be Sukkot, where you're gonna celebrate that and celebrate the new you. So Shana Tova, and love yourself, understand how much God loves you, and be the new person that you really yourself want to be. And that's the greatest celebration. That's the happiness of Rosh Hashanah. Shana Tova.